here right at Pioneer Chicken, right in East LA, and this is a very legendary shop. I first found out about this place from my coworkers. We only have 10 people at work, but two of them recommended it. That's over 20% of people recommended Pioneer Chicken. Apparently, it's like a super OG type. They used to have a bunch of stores down here. I'll get into that later. Make sure to stick to the end of the video for that. But they used to have a bunch of shops. Now it's only down to two. Very historic place. Legendary chicken. My coworker said they grew up on this stuff, and he's already in his 40s. If that sounds interesting, let's go in and try it out. Okay, so we're just going to dig in right now. We got our plate of chicken, four strips right here, a nice biscuit, a cup of coleslaw, I have to have that with anything fried, as well as the spicy rice. I'm not too sure what that is. It looks kind of clumped up. Maybe they mix in some kind of sauce to it. I see some chili flakes in it as well, but we're going to try that out. But first, let's get started with the big ticket item right here, the fried chicken. It's actually pretty greasy, but I heard that it's supposed to be super light and nice, so we're going to go for it. Before that though, I have to try out some of this sauce. I don't know if it's a ketchup or some kind of hot sauce. Yeah, let's just go for it. Put that on right here. That should be good. Let's take a bite. Okay, so immediately when I bite into it, the first thing I noticed was how thin the batter was. Really thin, easy to bite through it. At the same time though, the chicken inside was nice and tender, also seasoned well, so it's not really bland. And then the sauce that I got, I think it's kind of like a hot and sour type sauce, so it goes really well to balance out the crispiness that you find in the chicken. Yeah, really easy to eat, nice on the palate. Let me try mixing in some coleslaw with this, just to see how it contrasts. Let's try some of that, as well as some of the rice right here. Okay, that should be good. So let's try and get a piece that combines all of them. Okay, so let's try. We got some of the fried chicken right here, the spicy rice, and a bit of that mayo from the coleslaw. Let's try it out all at once. Okay, a lot of thoughts came to my head. First, the rice, it is indeed spicy, but it's kind of like got a Spanish rice texture to it almost. It's like definitely using the long grain type of rice, not like the Japanese medium grain. That's really good. And then, so the spiciness and also the heat, like the temperature heat coming from the chicken, is really tough on the tongue. It really hits you immediately, just like my Howlin' Ray's fried chicken video. Make sure to watch that right here if you haven't seen it already. But then at the end, you know, the mayo, the creaminess and the mayo that comes with it, it really balances everything out. You know, kind of cools the tongue because it's cold cabbage, and then the mayo as well, it takes care of the spiciness. It's overall a super good combination. Let's try out another big bite right here with the coleslaw on top with the rice. I'm just gonna finish it off. Lost for words, absolutely. This chicken, again, super nice and hot on the inside. Burns your tongue. Spiciness kicks in, it gets worse. Coleslaw finishes off at the end. Cools everything off. And this cabbage, it's almost sweet. I think they use some really ripe carrots. I don't know if carrots can get ripe or not, but they use those, and then so it's almost got a sweetness factor to it, along with the creaminess, along with the cold cabbage. So it works really well for balancing it out with the chicken right here. And then let's actually try something. I'm going to take another piece of the chicken, and then I'm going to break this biscuit in half. And then let's try making a sandwich of sorts. Okay, so we got that. whip that inside and then get some of this honey that they included. I know that honey is a super good combination with biscuit. If you guys have ever been to like KFC, they always include it. I think having anything sweet in foods is a super good combination. We had a lot of that in the Filipino food market tour in the previous series. Make sure to watch those two right here as well. But adding any kind of sweet factor to the regular dishes usually tends to work pretty well. But let's try it in this kind of biscuit sandwich right here. Ultimate. Mmm. Just like I was thinking. So in this case, the savoriness of the chicken is kind of amplified because it's in contrast with the sweetness that's coming from the honey, as well as also the natural sweetness that comes with yeast in the bread. Definitely a completely different flavor profile compared to eating it with the spicy rice and the coleslaw, but nonetheless a super good combination. We're just gonna keep chowing down on this. But just a bit of the backstory about this place. They used to have 200 restaurants throughout Southern California, but it got reduced. It was bought by the owner of Popeyes. The majority of them turned into Popeyes, but there are still two remaining ones here in LA. And this is one of them, independently owned. So it's legendary. They even had one like in Indonesia and Hawaii at one point. But yeah, this was Pioneer Chicken. If you like the video, make sure to like and subscribe. Let me know your thoughts down below. Thank you very much.